back with the Monday evening edition of the Valley's most in-depth weather forecast video. It's weather for weather geeks. Hope you had a good weekend. Our weather certainly turned around over the weekend. We're in the middle of a real treat for this time of the year. A long stretch of very unwinter-like, un-February-like weather, unlike on today's date 2 years ago. I'm going to do just a quick reminder this evening that, yes, it can snow at this time of the year. In fact, it can snow quite a bit at this time of the year, as we had in early February of 2022. Now, the storm was, I believe, the third into the fourth 2 years ago. But on today's date 2 years ago, the snow depth reported at the Youngstown Warren Airport was 13 inches. We had 17 inches on the ground back in 2015 on today's date. So not that long ago, we had some snow. You know, I get a lot of comments in the middle of stretches like this about, you know, never snows anymore and that sort of thing. You know, we can talk about long-term climate trends and things of that nature while also recognizing that it just suddenly didn't go from a whole bunch of snow for 6 months straight to no snow at all. You know, there's some nuance in this. And, you know, our memories tend to be kind of short on a lot of subjects, but especially when it comes to the weather. We just got done with a couple of very snowy decades. The 2010s and 2000s were both snowier than the average many, many times. Now, the 2020s have been the opposite of that. We were close to average back in 2020, but a fair amount below average for annual snowfall in 2021, 22, and 23, and well, so far in 24 as well. We had many years in the 2000s and 2010s where we had a lot of snow, including our snowiest year on record. The winter of 2010-2011 was remarkably snowy. We had 118 inches, I think, at the airport that winter. And, you know, that was only about 14 years ago. That wasn't like it was 100 years ago. So just a reminder that, you know, while the climate is certainly changing and we can document the changes to our weather around here with a lot of data, the data does show that while, yes, in general, we don't have as many sharp cold snaps and as sustained or sustained cold snaps that are, you know, really, really harsh as we used to, actually, the long-term snow averages are higher now than they were back in some of these really bad winters that we remember from the 70s and into the 80s. This goes along with a general increase in precipitation year-wide across our region. That's one of the hallmarks of climate change for our latitude, our part of the country. It's the increase in precipitation. Yes, temperatures are rising, but that isn't as noticeable of a change locally as the increase in both precipitation and snowfall in terms of the long-term averages. Of course, long-term averages are just that, they're long-term, and embedded in long-term averages are oftentimes years like this, where we're way below average in the snow department. As of today's date, 20.7 inches behind average. Look at that number in Erie, 50 inches shy of average through today's date. And these numbers are going to continue to climb for the next several days because, of course, we don't expect any snow through at least the upcoming weekend. Boy, do they have the snow and they have the rain in the West. If you've seen the pictures and video out of Southern California especially, they're pretty incredible. I mean, over a foot worth of rain in some low-lying areas over the last couple of days. Of course, much higher totals up in the mountains. You get high enough in the mountains, and of course, it is snow and a lot of it. That's why winter storm warnings are still out for the mountains around Los Angeles and up in the Sierra Nevada, Nevada mountains, I should say, and into the Intermountain West as well. Lots and lots of snow falling out there. Now, the pattern is going to start to settle down in the West in the coming days, signaling the start of a general pattern shift across North America, taking us through next week, and that means colder days are ahead for us. In the short term, after a fair amount of sunshine today, we have this bank of clouds that has been drifting slowly to the south and west, kind of an unusual direction to see clouds coming in from the northeast, moving in a southwesterly direction, but looks like a lot of our area is going to have some clouds for a time this evening, but then the sky will clear later on tonight, and as Tuesday gets underway, we should have lots and lots of sunshine, and it'll be kind of a rerun of today with wall-to-wall sunshine midday and afternoon. We'll make our way into the 40s. Now, as we go into the day on Wednesday, notice our wind direction is not necessarily due north anymore. It's more of an easterly component to the wind. That will allow temperatures to get a little bit warmer on Wednesday. I think we'll flirt with 50, perhaps even exceed 50 in some spots on Wednesday. And even warmer times are ahead on Thursday as this warm front out here lifts off to the north. We'll get into the mid-50s with some fair weather clouds, not as pristine looking that sky on Thursday as it was today and will be tomorrow, but still really, really nice for this time of the year. We're going to keep a dry forecast through Thursday evening, and then this system will slowly approach and finally bring some rain showers, scattering of rain showers to our area later on Thursday night and into the day on Friday. The pattern change is now in sight in the 10-day temperature outlook. Again, we're way above the average into the upcoming weekend. And then next week, we start to see the changes. Now, this isn't going to flip to just harsh Arctic cold or anything like that, but we are going to get back to where we kind of should be in the middle of February, and that means mid-30s for daytime highs right around Valentine's Day, and I do think that that pattern will continue for a couple of weeks. How cold? A little too early to talk about with any degree of confidence the magnitude of cold that we'll see in this pattern later this month and perhaps into the first part of March as well. But I do think that the colder than average days may outnumber the warmer than average days for a couple of weeks anyway during the second half of the month. Before we leave you this evening, let's talk longer range since there's not much to talk about in the short range. Today's the fifth day of the month, and that means we got an update on the seasonal outlooks from the European Center. This is broken down by months, but we can also look at seasons as well. And so we're looking at meteorological spring here, March, April, and May. Temperature anomalies. And overall, the map looks kind of like winter, with warm anomalies favored in the northern latitudes and perhaps near average to somewhat below average in the southern latitudes in North America. I do think, you know, I haven't looked at this super closely as of yet because it's only February the 5th, but I do think that the pattern right now and perhaps a couple of months into the future is going to resemble 1973. That was a strong El Nino winter, 72 into 73, but there were also other similarities in ocean temperatures elsewhere aside from the El Nino region that, and you know, I looked at the anomalies for January and February, they kind of resemble what we have going on right now. So playing that forward, what happened in 1973 in springtime? I can tell you that March was very warm in 1973. April and May, not so much compared to the average. But March was very, very warm. And this is the composite look for all 3 months, showing a cool spring in the southern tier and a mild spring across the northern tier of states. Kind of looks like some of the modeling I just showed you, which increases my confidence that this may be the right idea. So very early springtime thoughts. Perhaps it averages out as a little on the mild side. May kind of depend largely on how March goes. Again, March of 73 was very warm. Not necessarily saying that March of 2024 will be that warm. But, you know, it's interesting to look at how things are tracking so far this year with 1973. Also, 1973 spring was on the wetter side, and I kind of like that idea for this spring as well. We'll, of course, talk about the longer range, including the spring forecast, as we go towards the first day of meteorological spring on March the 1st. In the meantime, on this February the 5th, thanks for watching Weather for Weather Geeks. Easy for me to say. I'll see you back here on Tuesday.